Hey friends, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you two special tricks for iPhones that will help you take faster, more discreet, and more detailed notes, and with GPS location data attached to them. The only thing that you'll need is an iPhone and two pre-installed Apple apps, Apple Shortcuts and Apple Notes. You're going to learn how to quickly create and open a note preloaded with detailed GPS location data, and you'll learn my technique for writing over 150 words a minute without typing on your smartphone. These techniques are perfect for writers, journalists, researchers, creators, field techs, or anyone else who needs to take detailed and discrete notes with specific location and GPS data attached to them. And as a little bonus for watching, I'll give you a link to download my shortcut for free at the end of the video. So now, let's get into it. I use the Apple Shortcuts app to create a shortcut on my iPhone. A shortcut is basically a script, a set of instructions that you can program your Apple device to execute at the press of a button. I've named my shortcut Field Notes, but you can call yours whatever you like. When I press the Field Note shortcut, which I've placed on my home screen using a widget, the shortcut automatically creates a new note in the Apple Notes app with the date as its title and places the note into a special folder within the Notes app that I've also called Field Notes. After it creates the note, the shortcut opens the note and at the bottom pastes location data like date, time, weather conditions, temperature, coordinates, longitude, latitude, altitude, and at the bottom, an Apple Maps link. It basically collects a snapshot of where you are and appends that information to the bottom of the note. With the note now open, I can simply begin typing notes. The whole process takes only a few seconds, depending on your connection and your location. If I already have a note in the folder with the same title, the shortcut will just append more data to the bottom of the pre-existing note, so I can have multiple notes and multiple data points on one note. Now, that was the first hack, and here's the second trick, which is where the real magic happens. Instead of simply typing my notes using my thumbs, I use the voice-to-text dictation function to speak my notes. It works great, and I can dictate around 150 words a minute effortlessly, which is a lot more than I can write by hand or type. If you're out and about and you're working in the field, I found that using a good pair of earbuds is interesting because their microphones detect your speech without you having to hold the phone to your mouth. I use a pair of Soundcore Liberty 4 earbuds, which are half the price of Apple AirPods Pro, but they work extremely well for this purpose. Let me show you how to make the shortcut first so you can understand how it works, but after that, I'll give you a link to download it for free if you don't want to build it yourself.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up my Shortcuts app, and then you'll see here there's a list of all of my shortcuts. So the first thing I'm going to do is edit my Field Note shortcut by clicking on the or pressing the three dots on the top right corner of the Field Note button. And there we are, we're inside. So the first thing that you'll see here is that I'm fetching the current date. So the very first line is current date, and after that I'm going to format the date because I like to have my dates formatted by year-month-date, but you can format the date however you like. After it formats the date, it finds all notes in my Notes app that contain the formatted date, so year-month-date. It will then set the variable note, which you can name that variable whatever you want it to, but for the sake of simplicity, I just named it note. So I set variable note to the note that I'm trying to find. So here I have an if otherwise statement. So I'll say if my note has any value, open the note. So if my note has the value that I set, the formatted date, then it will open the note with the formatted date. If it doesn't find that otherwise, what it will do is it will create a note with the formatted date in my folder, Field Notes. You can see that here. And then this little button here will open the note after it's created. So I know that was a little bit difficult, but let's run that down really quickly to kind of explain what that's doing. So basically what I'm doing is I'm finding a note in my Notes app that has the title year-month-day. And if it can't find a note with that title, it's going to create a note with that title and then place it in my folder, Field Notes. That's all that that's doing. After that happens, the if otherwise statement, what I'm doing is I'm asking my shortcut to get my current location, and you can select the precision. And the more precise that it is, the longer that it takes. But I like to do best. I don't mind a few seconds of wait. And then I set a variable for current location to my current location. And from that variable, I'm snatching latitude, longitude, altitude, a maps URL, and the current weather stuff. After that, I want to have a text entry. So I like to have two spaces here, because if you append this to the bottom of the note and you don't have a space there, it's going to look weird. So I put two spaces for clarity. I have this text, new entry, and after that, a space or a new line. After that, what I'm going to do, what the shortcut is going to do rather, it's going to append that text information to my note. And after that, it's going to append all of that information that I just collected. So the date, the conditions, the temperature, the coordinates, all of that stuff, it's going to append that information to the note. After that, I'm going to append this little emoji there to the bottom of the note, just as a way, a visual reference for me to separate that data from the note that I'm going to type in after that. So I'm going to put my emoji there, append that information, and then that's it. And when I run this, it should automatically create a note and append that information. So let's test it here. I'm back at the shortcut screen, and I'm going to press Field Note. And boom, there it is. And now I can start typing.
And that's it. Just save the shortcut and add it to your home screen using a widget. And if you want to download the shortcut for free, I've placed a URL somewhere here on the screen, which you can go to and download it absolutely free. If you use the shortcut in your own note-taking workflow, or if you have any tips, questions, or suggestions, please drop them in the comments. And please like this video and subscribe to the channel. I'm told that these are ways that viewers can support channels for free to help them grow. So see you next time.